You know, Shakespeare did say, what's in a name? And I'll tell you what's in a name. Herpes. That's what's in a name. You need to get that prescription, girl. Get it, get it, get it. Hey, beautiful people, what is up? I hope that you guys are all having such an amazing day today, and I'm very excited for multiple reasons, okay? So number one, I have a popsicle, and I know it doesn't look like much of a popsicle right now because literally half of it just broke off in my mouth, and you know what? I just don't care because I've been on a popsicle kick lately. If you're new here, hi, I've got a brain tumor, and I go through like puberty, pregnancy, and menopause, so I have severe cravings constantly, and I have been on this popsicle kick now for a hot minute, and I'm talking, I've wanted popsicles to the point where like, if I could just not eat anything else ever again in my life, I would just eat popsicles because I have been craving them on an unhealthy level. So I'm eating popsicles because that was like my reward for getting through my first, you know, part of the day, which was the Blendiful. If you missed that, I did an update. I'll link it here for you. And it wasn't like a bad video or anything. It was more so like the video itself had not serious parts to it, but parts that didn't work out with the product. And if you missed it, obviously you can watch it. But like there were just certain aspects to it that really kind of bummed me out. And I needed something that was like a little more fun, like light and airy and just like, ha, like something that we could just decompress, we could talk, we could hang out, and I don't know, just relax. And to relax, girl, I wanted a popsicle. Now for today's video, I just realized I never introduced it, so my bad, I got a little sickle excited. But we're gonna be going through and talking about makeup I'm glad I didn't purchase. Some of it's newer, some of it's a little older. I tried not to go super, super old, so like I could stay somewhat current to current, just because that way, like whether you're new to makeup or you've been around for a hot minute, everyone has like some level of familiarity with it. But I wanted to do this video for a couple of reasons. One, I think we talk a lot about makeup we buy, what we like, what we don't like. We do anti-hauls, we do all that stuff. And I love all of those videos, but sometimes it's nice to know that I just didn't waste my money, period. Like I looked at it and I might've wanted it, I might've not, but either way, I was like, girl, you're not gonna get me. You are not gonna get your marketing practices into my little wallet. You are not gonna come all up in here, take all my money and mess with me. Like sometimes you just need that. And today's one of those days. So we're gonna do that. We're gonna eat this popsicle, that popsicle that I have on standby, and we're gonna talk about makeup I didn't buy, okay? Okay. Like that I'm just now getting to the first product and my first popsicle is already almost gone. Oops. But for me, this one is the same as another one, so I'm just gonna throw them both up on the screen. You have Kat Von D Lolita and you have the Charlotte Tilbury Pillow Talk Palette. Oh my word, you guys. Pillow Talk and Lolita are both, to their respective brands, the herpes of the makeup world, okay? I don't know what it is with brands having one color that goes off and it's just, woo, and it takes off. And I understand, like, you know, playing around with it, making like one or two things, and like, you know, you exploit the good fortune that is that shade. Totally understandable. But to the point where we are taking and quite literally making a mountain out of a molehill, I will never understand. Both of these, to my understanding, started as a lipstick, okay? Pillow Talk and Lolita. And then before you know it, Kat Von D, there's like Lolita 1, 2, 3, there's a palette, there's an eyeshadow, there's another eyeshadow, there's a freaking blush, like there's all these things and they're all Lolita. I'm like, are you trying to literally create a woman named Lolita? Because I, like, oh my God. And I'm just so glad I never bought these because I feel like, yes, the quality might have been great. I can't speak for Kat Von D because I haven't used anything from her in a long time, or from that brand, I should say, in a long time. But the Pillow Talk palette, I'm sure would be fine from Charlotte Tilbury. Like the quality, I'm sure would be fine because I've used lots of things. Quality's usually fine, but I just can't get past the fact that we're just with, like it just, I don't know what it is. It just, you know, Shakespeare did say what's in a name, and I'll tell you what's in a name. Herpes. That's what's in a name. You need to get that prescription, girl. Get it, get it, get it. So the next item we're going to talk about is from Tarte, and this is their Spicy Batch palette. Spicy Batch. And I think for me, the issues with this palette are multifold. Number one, it's only 8 shades, okay? And when I look at this, these 8 shades, like, I don't have an issue with them in theory, but on my skin tone, I would look bloodshot. My eyes would look all kinds of weird. I can't pull these shades. Number two, the swatches, if you're looking at the picture on the screen, and I don't know how well you guys can see it, but the swatches on the arm for this campaign look like they were made in paint with the airbrush filter on, like, a Windows 98. Like, I look at this and I'm like, these are blatantly fake. And if they're not fake, then someone went in with a literal paintbrush and painted that on with their finger, because I cannot for the light, like this is so, these are not, I don't know. Especially if you're looking at the shade Fierce, like you can't look at that shade and tell me that that is not from paint, Windows 98 with the spray paint filter. Like you just, you can't. So That's a whole nother thing. Like, the marketing, I do feel like the colors in here were, like, jacked around a little bit or something was done with it that's weird. I know it might sound trivial, like, to even put it in this video because, well, Paige, if it's not your color story, obviously you didn't buy it. But I was still tempted. And I just, I'm a little salty about it. One might say that I'm a little bit of a bitch about it. And, yeah, I am. Wouldn't want to be rude. Ooh. So the next one, I'm glad I didn't buy it just because, guys, I'm gonna be honest with you. I think it is so dumb. Like, I'm not trying to be mean. Okay, whatever. Everybody's gotta make their coin. You're getting inventive and I'll give you that. But y'all over at Beauty Blender, we need to have a talk. A color-changing beauty blender? What? Like, it's not even needed. Like, who's doing your makeup? Like, My Little Pony? I don't understand. My reasoning, it's quick and to the point. I'm glad I didn't buy it because I think it's a waste of money. And no, that's really not, like, technically the point of this video, but I'm feeling a little salty because I just feel like there's marketing here, and I don't like it when I can tell that I'm being marketed to. Like, the whole point of being a good marketing strategist is being able to sell without it being blatant. And I feel like they went into that room and they were like, all right, so here's the deal. Listen up, everybody. Grab your popsicles. Can you hear me? Okay, good. Let's all discuss. How can we make it look like we are just gonna oversell something that they don't need? They don't need to buy right now. How can we do it? And then one person raises their hand and they're like, you could put that it's a limited edition. Good idea. What's another idea? Oh, make sure that you put holiday special. Oh, good idea. What about an introductory special, but the price is actually the same? Yes, I like where you're going. Okay, let's make it exclusive. Like, and they just go through all of these things. And I feel like this product hit so many of those buttons for me that I'm just like, go away. It drives me nuts. I don't like it. This next thing, guys, I'm just like glad I didn't get it for multiple reasons. Again, it's from House Labs and it's their eyeshadow palette. And I almost fell for it, okay? Almost. I fell for the hype the first time. Everyone was like, oh my God, it's Gaga. Everybody's goo goo for Gaga. And I'm over here, cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. Like, it's a whole thing. It's what we do. We were literally raised on that marketing. For me, with this eyeshadow palette, you look at it, first of all, it is the most plain Jane ass eyeshadow palette. Okay, I'm just like, girl, you are Lady Gaga. And you couldn't come up with something that was more than this. I don't know. It's the same feeling that a lot of people had with her other products she launched. Same feelings I had. And I'm still a little salty because I purchased those. Amazon screwed up my order like 3 times. And by the time I got them all and purchased them and paid for them all, they got here so late I couldn't do a video. So like the whole customer service end around House Labs going through Amazon, I wasn't a fan of that. And even still with all that, I was tempted to purchase this thing. And I'm just so glad I didn't, because like it literally looks like not even half. I would say 80% of the palettes I own, because I'm a neutral little hoe, they look like this. And Y'all, this popsicle is almost melted. Okay, we gotta eat this real fast. So the next item I'm glad I didn't pick up is actually from ABH Norvina. There's two on the screen. The one that I almost picked up is the green yellow one. Like, I love that color story. I love the shimmery green in there, the purple. It looks so, so pretty. For me, the reason that I didn't pick this up is pretty simple. I just didn't like where my heart and like my headspace was at with ABH. I felt like they were cramming palettes down our throat. They blatantly, in my opinion, they just threw Jackie Ina's palette aside, and I'm sorry. I absolutely love this palette. It's sitting right here. I didn't stage that. It's just sitting here. I still wear it all the time. It's such an amazing palette, and I felt like it didn't so much as get a twinkle in the eye of what it deserved, because all they did was flood the market with palette after palette after palette, and I just didn't feel right. And you know, when it boils right down to it, obviously, like, Jackie's got her shit handled. Like, that has nothing to do with me. I just didn't like the feeling that I got from this brand, that I felt like they were trying to shove all this stuff down my throat, and they were just, there was something about it that was just so blatant and almost greedy, and I couldn't get behind it. I'm glad I didn't pick it up, because it wouldn't have been me. It wouldn't have been. All right, so the next one is the KKW Body Foundation, and you want to know the reason I'm glad I didn't pick it up, other than the fact that I didn't buy it, almost bought it, made fun of it, didn't buy it again. The real reason I'm glad I didn't buy it, get ready for it, grab your seats, it's a real humdinger, because I knew I wouldn't use it. Like, the fact that I even have to say that out loud is just, like, mind-boggling to me, that I still wanted to buy it. What does that tell you about the way that our the way that our media has built up stuff like this? The fact that I know, sitting here, and I consider myself not, like, the smartest person, okay? Like, I'm no Einstein, but I'm also not, like, you know, completely inept. Like, I have got some brain power to me. I like to consider myself relatively intelligent. And the fact that I know I wouldn't use it, but I considered it anyways, is mind-boggling to me. And for those of you that are wondering, like, Paige, I've got this. It's a great product. It works really well. Like, I love it. Why wouldn't you use it? Is there something? I'm not saying nothing against the product, nothing against you, nothing against any of that. But here's my reality, all right? I live in Northern Michigan. Northern Michigan. That is land of the tractors. That is land of snow. That is land of fudgies. That is land of I never stop working. So at best, I would have this product in my repertoire of makeup that I would literally never use. There's like a 2 month span, 3 months, maybe a year where my legs even might see daylight. And that is assuming that they are like shaved, the outfit is good, like everything has to align, like Orion's belt has to be in perfect alignment with everything. I don't even know if that's a good analogy, but you get what I'm saying. All the planets have to line up perfectly for my pasty vampire ass legs to see daylight. And I wouldn't use this on my arms because I got hair on my arms, and it's just not my thing. Like, I would never use it. And so I'm glad I didn't buy it because I wouldn't use it. This next one almost got me, and I still don't understand how, because I remember from the moment I saw it thinking, huh? And that is the Too Faced Extra Spicy Palette. How? This is a marketing gimmick in every single way, and I just can't. I almost fell for this. I'm so glad I didn't. I almost did. And when I look at this, like, I get like mad at myself because, first of all, not even mad at me, girl. Hold on. First of all, mad at Too Faced. What the hell are you looking at this thing telling me this is extra spicy? You want to show me the spice? I'm waiting. Where the hell is the spice? There's no spice in here. This is the most bland, neutral palette, and there's green. Is that supposed to be your sprinkle? That's your cilantro? Just like, and that's it. That's all you get. I can't with this palette. It was a marketing gimmick in every way. This is coming from the girl that did really like the gingerbread palette, the one they released 2 years ago, the original. That was a good palette. I don't think that it was like, wow, you know, suck me sideways as amazing as everybody said it was, but it was a good palette, and I just feel like, they took the same pan, the same everything, and they like tweaked like two shades, moved everything around, and they're like, boom, extra spicy, bam, emerald. And I just, no. What the hell are you doing? I got this one rat tail sticking out beside my ear. How long you been there, buddy? All right, so it is dark outside. I just realized I talk for so long, so let's just kind of speed round. All right, next one here. We have Lime Crime Venus Immortalis Palette. This thing, oh my gosh, I had this in my cart for so long at Ulta. Like, I hemmed and hawed for weeks about this palette, and I'm so glad I didn't get it, because no sooner do I take it out of my cart and consider putting it back in do I hear Teresa, Lemus Teresa from Teresa is Dead, if you have not watched her, oh sweet baby Jesus, but she hates this palette. She's like, it is hard pan, it is awful, there's no pigmentation, it's trash. And I'm like, ooh, I'm so glad I didn't buy that. And y'all, this is $38. Like, we're not, you know, this ain't chump change, okay? So I was really glad that I like waited, and I mean, Teresa girl, I'm sorry that you bought it, but like, I'm glad I didn't, because it's not good. All right, guys, I need both my hands free for this. The Beauty Blender brushes that also had the skincare balls on the other side. What? Like, I just, oh my God, what are you doing? Oh my God. See, I knew I'd need both hands because I had to clap my way through this. Guys, can someone please explain to me, when are you doing your makeup? Okay. And maybe I'm the only one. Like, maybe I just do my face and makeup and skincare weird. Okay. That has possibilities. But please explain to me, when are you putting on your makeup and going, oh gee, let me just, oh wait, hold on. Good thing I've got this round skincare ball so I can depuff my under eyes real quick while I'm, you know, putting on my blush. Who does that? Am I the only one that doesn't? Is there some step to skincare that I'm missing? Or is this like one of those ideas that you're just like, huh? Like when you don't want a dog, when you make a weird noise and they go, huh? And they like put their ears up and they're a little, and they're all confused. That was me to this product the whole time. And I kept asking myself, is there something I'm not getting? Because I'm not saying the brushes are bad quality, but what the hell is the point of this? Am I doing my makeup all wrong? Do normal people go like, blushy, 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 and rollerball? Like, is that a thing? Because it's not a thing in my world. I guess it's not a rollerball. It's just a big metal ball stick thing. And I just don't get it. All right, you guys, I'm gonna stop here. Let me know your thoughts and opinions down below. Are there any of these that you did pick up that you liked, you didn't like, you felt the same way on, products that you're glad you didn't buy, any of that sort of thing, leave it in the comments. And let me know while you're down there too. Do you like this type of video? Yes, no, not so much. Cause I know it's a little different, but it's also fun. And it's just razzy zazzy and all kinds of jazzy. And I'm having a good time. So let me know your thoughts and opinions down below. If you haven't checked me out yet on Instagram and on Twitter, those will be linked in the description box. But most importantly, if you have not done so, please don't forget to subscribe and turn on your post notifications. I do upload 3 videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and they go up between 6 and 7 a.m. my time here in Northern Michigan. And you guys, that is everything. Thank you all so much for watching. Please don't forget to have a great day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Hey, beautiful people. I hope that you are having... Okay, could you be louder, sir? Sir. Okay. Almost missed my mouth. Okay, that was really rude. I'm gonna have to ask that no more of my popsicle fall on the floor. Are you a spicy batch? Because I'm a spicy batch. We're all just spicy batches, aren't we? Spicy, wow.